What up, everyone? Welcome to Cold Ansha Live. I am Miggy, and I am the host of the show and a parasite. What's up, everyone? Hey, it's me, Misaki. Welcome to Cold Ansha Live. Hey, I thought, you know, it's the Halloween's right around the corner, so I wanted to dress up as something. So today I am Shinichi and Miggy from the classic show, Cold Ansha series, Parasite. But today, it's actually not about Halloween at all. Today's episode is going to be focused on this rom-com series that you may know of from the anime called Girlfriend, Girlfriend. I'm very excited to share a brand new interview with the creator, Hiroyuki Sensei, in a little bit. But before we get into that, we have some new announcements that you might be interested in for the November digital titles, digital debuts. If you didn't know, Kodansha has been releasing brand new series every week on digital platforms, so that, you know, it might not be available in print yet, but it gives you a taste of new manga each and every week. So that's actually something kind of amazing. So today I'm sharing you the list of new series that's coming out in November. Let's check it out. Alright, so starting with November 2, it's gonna be Cells at Work, Neo Bacteria is gonna be debuting. As you can see, this is a spin-off of the famous Cells at Work series by Akane Shimizu. But instead of focusing on the cells, they're focused on the other microbes, the bacteria. And specifically, these bacteria live in a host of a teenage girl. And she's going through like a typical kind of growth phase of the teenagers. She's going through changes in her bodies and also her feelings, which puts these bacteria into a lot of work. Namely, for example, it starts out like kind of devastating looking like battle scene between the good bacteria and the bad bacteria. And the good bacteria are not doing so well because the host, the teenage girl, decided to go on a diet, being kind of insecure a little bit about her body. And she also was kind of like lovesick with this boy at her school. So you know, from inside and out, they tried to encourage her to eat right so that she would be actually a healthy person. Oh, not to mention her love interest is also interested in a healthy person. So I think it's all in everybody's interest to keep our body healthy during time like this. Anyways, that's Cells at Work, Neo Bacteria. That's debuting on November 2nd. Next one up. Cells at Work, White Brigade. So this one is also another Cells at Work spinoff. As you know, that in the main series, the white blood cell is one of the central characters who interacts with our favorite main character, the red blood cells. They're like the buddies since way back when. But at this point in this new story, the white blood cell is like a veteran, and he has a whole lot more responsibility than before, such as training the rookie white blood cells, or you know, all his other colleagues are just causing a lot of trouble for him to clean up. Too bad he's kind of a responsible time and he would deal with it. But anyways, so it's about these kind of a funny relationship between the co-workers of the white blood cells. And they all happen to be some sort of ikemen at the same time. So it's if you're interested in that, this might be a series for you. It's just as funny as the main series. Check it out when it comes out in November 9th. Next one up. Anyway, I'm Falling in Love with You by Haruka Mitsui. This is a brand new shoujo series. It's really what's interesting about it is that this is the first manga that I've actually seen that mentions of the pandemic. So in this world, the pandemic has happened, and they're all it's sort of kind of bummed out about the fact that they didn't really get to go through the usual, you know, school life that everybody was looking forward to going through in like high school and stuff. But because of the situation, the story is focused around very close-knit relationship between these five childhood friends. One is a girl, there's like four boys who grew up together in the neighborhood. And they are like really, really close to each other. And they're like families to each other, right? But then as they grow older, like they start to kind of have like different feelings towards each other, which gets revealed throughout the story. Namely, one of the childhood friend boy who Mizuha, the main girl, thought was kind of like a, you know, like her little brother since way back, basically confessed to her that he likes her with he steals her away with just one kiss, and then things start to kind of turn like real quick. She also has like a different love interest who is like a senpai from like a swim club, which one of the boys also in too, and but because of the pandemic, they don't get to go to competition. They don't get to, you know, like tell them feeling that they were going to tell to another person after the final competition was done. It's sort of dramatic, but it's also kind of like encouraging in a way. Hey, like you can actually have a really good relationship and you can make memories with your friends even if you're not in the usual school setting that you were expecting to be in. So anyways, I'm Falling in Love with You. That is coming out in November 16th. Okay, next one up. With You and the Rain. It kind of sounds like a love story, but it's actually a, this is not a love story. It's a story focused around this lady who one day picks up this quote unquote dog. We're not entirely sure if it is actually a dog. It looks like a tanuki raccoon to me. But she's totally sold on the idea that this is actually a dog. He talks to her was creatively using this like sketchbook and a pen, and he could communicate through like writing with her. So there's some basic language communication going on there, but aside that, they're just actually get along really well as like I don't want to really say roommates, but like a new relationship between a dog and a human, I guess. And it's this series actually started off as a webcomic, or actually it was like a Twitter comic. So as you can imagine, it's like a very short segment of like really punchy, cute stories back to back. So if you're like a sucker for an animal, this might be like a series for you. I'm totally into this stuff too. And like, not to mention like the illustration is like so pretty, so it's really enjoyable to read. So when With You and the Rain comes out on November 23rd, please check it out. All right, and the last one is the Iceblade Sorcerer Shall Rule the World. This one is actually based off of a very popular novel, and it's kind of an isekai series, but it's also kind of set up sort of similar to like Harry Potter. I think that's like more of a comparison than any other isekai series. And then it sets a place in a place called the Arnold Academy of Magic, which is like a total like a school for the sorcerers, like total elitist. The more from the good and famous family you're from, like you're highly respected in this school. Into this environment enters this ordinary guy, quote unquote, who doesn't seem to be particularly skilled with magic, or he seems like kind of a funny guy. And not everybody in school like him, but except like people, like other weirdos, like the girl behind him She's actually elitist of all elitists, like from like really famous like sorcerer family, but she really doesn't care about that kind of stuff. So she starts to actually, become friends with him. And together they start to kind of form a crew of kind of like odd friends at the school, going through different missions. And actually, off the bat, we get this hint that this main character is like this really powerful sorcerer that stopped like this really like devastating situation with his power, but he's kind of like hiding his abilities. So the more the story progresses, we get to find out what is his true power, like what is his ability, and is he really like the sorcerer who could rule the world. So I'm actually really curious about it and following it myself. Looking forward to it as it comes out. The first volume comes out in November 30th. Okay, I went through that really quickly, but if you're interested, there's more information available on kodansha.us. Some of them actually has a chapter one preview for free, so if you wanted to take a look at the manga, you can do that on our website. But also, you can also go ahead and head over to your favorite digital retailers such as Comixology, Google Play, Kindle, Nook, and Isneo for any pre-orders so that you won't forget about it. Like, it will be in your shelf by the time it comes out on the street there. So it's a good way to go if you want to remind yourself and not miss out. Okay. And now, Shinichi, where is the girlfriend? Okay, like I haven't really forgot about that yet either. Sorry, Migi. I know Migi's been kind of crazy about girlfriend since like the anime has been on. He's been hooked to it. But today we got a chance to talk to the artist, Hiroyuki, who is also the creator of the series Aho Girl. Really funny guy, but he's also very intelligent and he has some really great insights about making manga. So today I am sharing you a brand new video called Drawing Manga with Hiroyuki of Girlfriend. So I hope you're ready. Let's check it out. Have you ever fallen in love with more than one person at a time? What if those feelings are so real that you can't bear the thought of just choosing one person? And how can you even choose when each person is incredible in their own ways? Well, there's a manga that explores into this topic head-on with honesty, open-mindedness, and a whole lot of comedy. And it's called Girlfriend by Hiroyuki from Kodansha. You may recognize this creator's name from his previous work, Aho Girl. Today, we've got a chance to interview Hiroyuki Sensei in person to ask him questions about his creative process and his personal life. Let's check out what he has to say. Hiroyuki 先生、こんにちは。
あ、こんにちは。
今日はインタビューに来ていただいてありがとうございます。
はい、ありがとうございます。
まず質問を始める前に一つ気になってたんですが、今いらっしゃるのはスタジオですか？ジムですか？
ああ、スタジオで仕事場です。 まあ趣味というか、まあ、健康維持のための、まあ、その筋トレグッズみたいなのが置いてあるんです。
今連載されている彼女について今日は、たくさん質問を聞きたいと思います。
はい、あ、はい、お願いします。
その今連載されている彼女が、まず始まったきっかけを教えてください。
もともと僕がウェブでちょっと書いて、まあ、それを、まあ、少し何本か書いてて、で同人誌とかに出したんですが、まあ、思ったよりも、まあ、好評だったので、でそれをちょっと講談社の編集さんと、まあ、連載向きにちょっと、まあ、そのよりパワーアップさせて連載にしていこうって形になって始めたですね。
じゃあこの、彼女の前に前作の「アホガール」っていう作品が、ひろゆき先生の、一番長い連載でしたね。 その後にその彼女も彼女を連載始める際に何か影響はありましたか？
やっぱそのアホボールって結構もうその 純粋なギャグ漫画としては僕の中ではもうかなりそのやりきった感があったので、まあ、今回はやっぱ次何か書くんだったらもう少しそれにその、まあ、笑いの要素はもちろんあってもいいんですけどプラスアルファで何か欲しいなっていうのがあって、まあ、今回そのじゃあそのラブコメ、ラブプラス笑いみたいな感じで、まあ、やっぱやったんですね。あと、なぜやっぱその、ずっと今までその、アホガールも含めなんですけども、1話完結のこう、まあ、まとまった話をポンポンポンと書いていく方がすごく多かったので、ちょっと今回はその、ストーリー性とかそういうのがある漫画を書いてみたいなって思ったところも大きかったですね。
その、あの、コメディ、ラブにコメディを入れる。コメディにラブを入れるときに、はい、なんか抵抗とかありませんでしたか？
あ、最初は どうなるんだろうっていうのはちょっと正直、まあ、なんか不安なところも大きかったですね。そのなんか僕にそういうなんか恋愛事みたいなのってなんかどうなるの書けるのかなみたいな、なんかそういうのはあったところは、まあ、正直なところといえばあるんですが、やっぱその題材がやっぱ題材でやっぱこう日本の中でもこの二股みたいなのがどの程度受け入れられるかっていうのはちょっとどうなんだろうなって思いながら書いてた部分でもあり、それがこう世界ってなるともうそれこそ全く予想ができないんですよね。こうだから逆に文化のによってはいいじゃん二股ってなるかもしれないし、文化によってはもう絶対こんなの許せないっていう文化の多分地域もあると思うんですよね。だからその辺がこうわからなすぎて逆に楽しんでいただけたんだったらもうとにかくそれはもう素直に嬉しいなっていう。
漫画家になりたいと思ってたきっかけとか、苦労したこととかありますか？
はいはい、まあそうですね、きっかけは多分10歳ぐらいの頃になんか漫画家っていう仕事を知って、まあなんかまあ当時の子供としては漫画描いてるだけで仕事になるっていうのがすごく、まあ、なんか簡単そうというか、まあ、楽そうに覚えたっていうのがまああって、でなんかあと多分なんか長者番付とか見たんでしょうね、きっとすごい儲かってるみたいななんか感じで、あ、漫画描いてるだけでこんなにお金もらえるんだ、いいなみたいな、なんかそういう割とこう簡単な気持ちで目指し始めて、でもまあ結局でもずっとそこから漫画家になりたいって言ってて、まあ中学生になってまああの原稿用紙とペンで書いてなんか持ち込みだと持ち込みなり投稿するんだよっていうのを知って、でそこから、あ、じゃあやってみようって言って書いて始めましたが、まあ全然うまくはいかなかったですね、もう本当に。そこから19歳ぐらいまでずっと、まあ年に2本ぐらいかな、投稿したり、そのまあ持ち込み行ったりもしてたんですけど、全然うまくいかず、まあ、なかなか難しいなと思ってたら、まあ、でそこからまあウェブでちょっとなんか漫画描き始めたら、そこからちょっとうまくいって、まあ、最終的にはデビューできたって形なんですけど、
なんかウェブで今連載されてからって言ってたのに何かそこで変わりましたか？
まあ、自分のホームページでこう漫画を描いて、そのでそれを最終的に同人誌で売りたいと思ってたんですよね。ただ同人誌で物を売るってことをイメージしたときに、同人誌の即売会の会場ってものすごい広い会場にものすごいたくさんのブースが出るんですよ。で、その中で自分の本を買ってもらえるイメージが全くわからなかったんですね。その、じゃあどうやったら買ってもらえるかって思ったら、とにかく知ってもらわなきゃどうしようもないな。自分っていう存在を知ってもらって、もう自分のところに来てもらう。目標ってことは自分のところに来ることを目的にして来て、その会場に来てもらわないと絶対買ってもらえないなと思って、その会場でたまたま読んでもらって、たまたま買ってもらうみたいなことは多分ほぼありえないと思ってたんで、じゃあどうやって知ってもらうかっていうことでホームページで自分の漫画を載せて宣伝する。で、どういう漫画を書けばみんなが自分に注目してもらえるか、自分のことを印象に残してもらえるかっていうのを、こう、いろいろ考えて試してやっていった。結論結果として、あ、漫画ってこういう風に書くと読者の心に残るんだみたいなことがだんだん分かっていったみたいな形でしたかね。
すごく計画的な進め方ですね。ま
あ、でももう多分結構その時は崖っぷちだった感じですね。もうなんか闇雲に当ててもダメだってことは本当に10代のうちに分かったんで、 20代になって始めたのがそれだったかもしれない。
集中し始めたんですね。
そうですね。
と例えば、なんか、影響を受けた漫画の作品とか作家さんとか、あと漫画じゃなくてもなんか創作的な意味ですごい影響を受けたなっていうものってありますか？
漫画で言うと多分僕のその作風というか、なんか漫画作りにおいてはおそらくアズ漫画大王っていう漫画があって、まあ、それがすごく漫画の作り方としては影響を受けてますよね。その、まあ、キャラクターの見せ方であったりとか、ちょっと一見冷静にこの人考えるとちょっと変な人というか、ちょっとなんか印象悪い人なんじゃないかっていう人も書き方によってなんか面白く魅力的にことができるみたいな、なんかそういう、僕はそういう風になんか受け取って、じゃあこの考え方ができれば結構変なキャラクターも魅力的に書くことができるなぁと思って、そこで結構いろいろと影響を受けましたね。その作家としてのなんか影響を受けたのは赤松健先生がすごく大きいです。やっぱこう漫画をロジカルに捉えて、作家性っていう部分とその、まあ、ビジネスっていう部分を本当にうまく両立させてる先生だなと思ってて、そのあたりは僕もすごくずっとファンで、こうなんかいろんなテキストとか読んで、なんかこう影響を受けてたと思います。
彼女も彼女の、アニメ、が今期始まってすごい大人気になったんですけれども、ご自身はご覧になりましたか？
ああ、もちろん、はい。
全部どうでしたか？ご感想。
そうですね。やっぱこう、声がついて、やっぱ、なんかこう、動きが出ると、やっぱりなんかこう、なんでしょうね、その、存在感が増すっていう感じが一番大きかったなって思います。まあ、その結果として、なんか、直也くんのイカレ具合がよりイカレてるなっていう感想はすごくあったんですけども、でもやっぱ、すごくやっぱ、世界にやっぱ奥行きが増したなって感想がすごく大きかったですね。
アニメを見てた時に思ったんですけれども、この彼女の彼女を始める時にこうひろゆき先生わざアートスタイル変えましたか？
ああ、そうですね。やっぱその絵の描き込みとかその描き込み方自体も結構変えましたね、はい。
非常にそのアニメとして映えるその色の付け方だとかキャラの立て方とかそういったところも含めて、なんかすごいこれはここまで計算されているのかとちょっと感じてしまったんですけど、どうですかね。
今まで描いた漫画がやっぱギャグだったので、その感じと同じ感じで絵を描いたらやっぱりラブコメに見えないなっていうのがまずあったので、まずラブコメに見える絵柄にしようっていうのはもう大前提としてあったので、だいぶやっぱそこら辺は他の作品とか参考にしつつ、どのくらい描けばいいのかなっていうのを割と考えて、まあ、ちょっと自分の絵柄を調整したりはしましたね。
結構その漫画家志望の人とか作家さんがどういったツールを使ってるのか結構気にしてると思うんですけど、はいはい、実はひろゆき先生YouTube で結構見せていらっしゃいますよね。
あ、はいはいはいはい。
YouTube を通して始めたのかなとお聞きしたくて。
おー、いや、なんか YouTuber 楽しそうだなっていうだけですけど
一番こうやってて楽しいこととかってありますか？
やっぱ仕事でずっと家で一人でやってるんで割と寂しいので、なんか配信とかしながらやってると割となんかその寂しさが紛らわされるのでいいなっては思いますけどちなみに彼女も彼女のプロトタイプも最初 YouTube の配信でやりながらネームを書いてたんで、実はどっかに残ってますね。
じゃあその画像を見たければひろゆき先生の YouTube に GO って感じですね。
そうですね、はい。
それからそうやって新しいそういう、ね、投稿もそうやって要は雑誌で見る紙面で見るよりもだいぶ早く見れるということはかなりスクープ感があるので私もフォローします。
はい、ありがとうございます。
じゃあ最後の方になってきましたけど、今後その彼女も彼女はどうなっていくのかっていうことを今言える程度ちょっと教えてください。はいはいはい。
まあ、ミリカや、まあ、ミリカとシノがやっぱどんどん大きく関わってきて、まあ、結果として佐々木渚直也、まあ、これからどうしていくのかっていうのがよりこうどんどんこう深く考えなきゃいけないパートにはなっていっていると思うので、 そのミリカとシノがこの佐々木渚直也とどういうふうな、まあ、結末を迎えるのかっていうところがやはり今後のメインのシナリオにはなっていくので、そこをこう楽しみに見ていただけたらいいなと思っております。まあ、もちろんそのコメディ的な笑いのシーンとかも、まあ、どんどん盛りだくさんで入れていきますので、その辺も含めて楽しんでいただけたら嬉しいなと思います。
どうもありがとうございました。
ちょっとありがとうございました。
That was really cool. Hey, you know, like usually manga artists are really, really shy and they don't tend to show their face or come out to the public. So it's really like rare occasion for me to interview creators like Hiroyuki sensei in person, face to face. I guess more like face to face because it's over a call.But I'm so, so happy to be able to have this kind of interaction with him. And I really hope to do something like this in the near future too. And thank you so much for Hiroyuki sensei to, for agreeing to do this. And I hope you guys also get to check out his YouTube channel that was mentioned in the video. Let's see. So I, when we announced this, episode for Girlfriend Girlfriend Special, we promised you guys that we will be conducting a fan Q&A, and a lot of you submitted questions and then we translated it and sent it to Hiroyuki sensei. However, unfortunately this time he was his schedule got too busy with his weekly manga schedule, and then so unfortunately this time he didn't get to answer yourquestions this time around, but hopefully that the interview itself covers some of the questions that you were interested in. And also I really hope to do another fan Q&A with Hiroyuki sensei in the near future, this time for real. So just letting you know that. And our friends at Anime Corner, there's like a website that has an exclusive interview with Hiroyuki sensei that has its own really interesting take on this conversation. So I hope you get to check them out as well. And after this episode, I am planning on putting this interview video as well as the brand new sketch video on our YouTube channel as well. So I hope you get to see it once again, and would you, I would appreciate it if you let your friends know about it too. Let's see. Next episode. Let's talk about next episode. So next episode is going to be on November 21st, and then we're going to be at Anime NYC. That's right. The conventions are coming back, and Kodansha is going to be in the Big Apple with a huge, huge Attack on Titan gallery that is coming to you. And I hope you'll be there, but in case if you don't, not to worry, because we will be live streaming some of the announcements from that we'll be making from the show. So you'll be able to find out what is coming up in the new licensing announcement for fall 2022. At the same time as the people who will be at the show. So this will be the first time we'll be doing this, and bear with us for now, but like it'll be really fun. And I if you see me at the show, please tell me what's up, and then we'll have a little interview with you too, maybe. Okay. Let's see, that is it for this episode. Thank you for tuning in, and I hope to see you in the next episode coming up. Stay tuned to our YouTube channel for the time for the next episode. There will be a premiere page that we set up right after this show. And I hope to see you soon. Peace. Bye.